Going on, everybody. Damon here, and today I'm going to be putting some new strings on my guitar. Received these in the mail. These are the Dunlop Heavy Core guitar strings. So from bottom to top, we got 10, 13, 21, I think. I don't know what that is. These other ones are here. This one. And the thickest one, which is a 60 gauge. Right. I'm gonna mix them up. First things first, I'm going to tune the low B. This is the ESP guitar here. And yesterday, as I was practicing, the zipper of my bag got caught with the E string and the string came off, so I was like, you know what, not a big deal, I'm gonna put some new strings on anyways. So I'm gonna tune this all the way down, a low B string. Can you hear it? Pretty sure you can hear it right now. Super loose right now. I had these strings on for about 2.5 years. It's crazy. It's getting loose. My uncle took me to a music store in my area and bought some strings. I'm like, yeah. These are just the Ernie Ball, Cobalt, you know, the little slinky top and bottom skinny strings, whatever. So next thing you're gonna do, I don't know if you can see it right here. Down in the back of the guitar on the bottom are these little pins. But before we take the strings out, and make sure this is finally getting loose. Haven't done this in so long, it's getting loose now. But this guitar, honestly, this guitar, and I'm pretty sure other electric guitars are pretty easy to tune. I think what we're gonna do is, yeah, I'm just gonna making sure this goes out, so I think I got it. Got it. So you have to unwound it from the little one of the pegs on the top before you poke me almost. Alright. So you have to unwind it from the little peg. And then what you do, like I said, right here, This is where the string comes out of, so you... You're going to pull it. I don't know if you can see it right there, so it's coming out of the little bridge pin right there. So I'm gonna take that out. So I'm gonna just put this in my pocket so I won't lose it. So most importantly, you take the strings off this guitar, the old ones, before you put the new ones on, or else you'll mix the old strings with the new ones. It'd be a shame to do that. Alright, so we're gonna retune the G string, the third string. This is getting loose here. Like I said, this is like the easiest guitar to take strings off of. Acoustics are different. They have the little bridge pins like on this area here. And then you would have to reach down into the hole of the guitar to grab it out, or use like a tool to pull the pins out before you take the strings off. Yeah, but this is the easiest guitar to take strings off of, so. Yeah, it's getting loose. Alright. So I'm going to bear with me, guys. This is a lot of work. Taking strings up. Alright. The reason why I keep putting the guitar up and down is I'm trying to find a way to take the strings out, so. Trying to unwrap the string that's connected to the little peg post, they call it. And once again, with the third one, you pull it from the bridge pin. There we go. String number three, all gone. All right. Now we're going to go down to the D string. So I'm going to keep track of those. String number four. On a lot of other seven string guitars, there's some pegs on one side of the guitar and a set of other pegs on the other side. But on this one, all seven tuning pegs are on one side instead of three on one side and then four on the other side of the guitar. Detuning the D string. So that's gonna be easy to get loose here. So just detuning this again. Ooh. I didn't have to unwind it from the post. That one just slipped out. So we're gonna take that out. Most importantly, when you take strings out, make sure not to lose the pegs. Yep, one almost popped off. But yeah, so all right, string number 5. We're almost done. I need to take this to my local guitar center. It's a little far from me, about 30 minutes or so. So they could set this guitar up. It's a good guitar, but I was planning on trading it in. But I keep this and get another one as a backup. I have two guitars. I have the M17. My second guitar would be a Jackson JS-22-7 Dink. So we're just making sure this one's like super loose. Make sure not to lose the little pen that's on the bottom. There we go. Pens are still intact on the bottom of the guitar, on the back. Now, they're poking me too. Alright, it's alright. Alright. Second to last string, string number 6. Here, there's a string sticking out right here. There we go, and that's the one my uncle didn't cut out. Cut the top part off as well. He helped me put these strings on this one, you know, these strings, and he didn't cut a piece off. So good, because good news is, this one's gonna come off like that. There we go. Same steps. You pulled it from the bottom. Alright. There we go. I think what I'm going to do to make it less of a hassle is to put all these to lay these inside. These are gonna chunk. That's what I'm gonna do. Alright. Last but not least, the B string. There's a lot of fret buzz in this guitar. The only thing I do not like about this guitar, it's a good 7-string for beginners, but man, that's just terrible. getting there. It's getting there. It's coming off. This is the thickest string on a 7-string. It feels like telephone wire. Weird. I don't know what it feels like. There we go. So it's fretless. Alright. Ooh. Pins almost popped. Alright, let me see. This one is a pin in the neck to get off. There we go. That one almost popped off the pin. Alright. As you guys can see there, wow, don't come off. And wants to pop off. So before you put your string on, let me show you this. This is what the guitar looks like with no strings. Alright. Looks good, does it? Continue with part two. Well, actually, we'll continue right now. I'll go to part two right now. So, starting off with the first string. Bottom to top.